Hi people, welcome to my channel. I'm Arpita Karwa, and in this video I'm going to talk about logical reasoning and the types of questions you might come across in the exam hall. So this video is a part of the paper 1 series that I'm running on my YouTube channel. So if you are preparing for UGC NTA NET paper 1, then this particular video lecture series is for you. So do subscribe to this channel. Also click the bell icon so that you are notified every time I post a video on UGC NET paper 1. So if you look at the question paper, you'll find that from the section of logical reasoning, two kinds of questions are asked in NET exam. The first kind of question concerns with the theoretical portion of logical reasoning. So you'll be asked definition and some important theoretical concept. And the second kind of question that you'll see are the practical questions in which you have to use your brain and then solve the question according to the theoretical concepts. So we'll start with the theoretical kind of questions and then gradually we'll move towards the practical portion. So the first kind of question that you will encounter is about argument. Okay, you will be asked about what is an argument, what is a premise, what is a conclusion. So let's first understand what is an argument. In an argument, you will have two things. One is the premise, which is sentences which supports the argument, and one is the conclusion. For example, if I give you an argument saying that Aditya was driving his car over speed and Aditya was drunk, therefore, Aditya was breaking the law. Now, this is an argument. In this argument, we have two premises. First one is Aditya was driving his car over speed limit. And the second premise is Aditya was drunk. These are the two things which support the conclusion. And what is the conclusion? That Aditya is breaking the law. So this is what an argument is all about. So argument will have premise and will also have conclusion. So you must know what is a premise, what is a conclusion, and what makes an argument. So now, once we are done with the theoretical portion, now let's move on to the second kind of questions that you will see in the paper. Now, after looking at what is argument, it is important to know how many types of arguments are there. So if we divide arguments, we have two major kinds of argument. One is the inductive argument and other one is the deductive argument. Deductive argument moves from general to specific. For example, if I say that all men are mortal, that means har aadmi marta hai, Socrates is a man. Now, on the basis of these two premises, I can conclude that Socrates is mortal. Agar har aadmi mar jata hai aur Socrates ek aadmi hai, to Socrates bhi mar jayega. This is what is called deductive argument. You are moving from general to specific. General tha, all men are mortal. This is a general statement. And you move to specific. Socrates is a mortal man. Okay. Now moving on to the another type of argument, which is inductive argument. Inductive argument moves from specific to general. For example, if I say Earth revolves around Sun, Mercury revolves around Sun, and I know that Earth and Mercury are planets, so I can conclude that all planets revolve around Sun. So maine specifically Earth revolves around Sun, Mercury revolves around Sun, and then I move to a general notion, which is all planets revolve around Sun. Now, if you look at these two categories, they are subdivided. Deductive argument has two kinds of argument. One is valid argument and one is invalid argument. For example, all animals have hair, and I say that John has hair, and I conclude that John is an animal. Now, this is not true, of course. It is not valid because all animals have hair. That is acceptable. John also has hair, but John is an animal. This is invalid. So this is a kind of invalid argument. Similarly, inductive argument are further divided in two parts, strong argument and weak argument. So you must be aware of what is inductive argument, what is deductive argument, what is strong argument, what is weak argument, what is valid argument and what is invalid argument. The next kind of theoretical question that you might see in the question paper is about types of definition. Types of definitions also come under logical reasoning. So there are various types of definition out of which the common ones are stipulative definition. Now, what is a stipulative definition? कोई भी definition जो नई चीजों के लिए आ रही है. For example, selfie, ये एक बहुत ही 21st century term है जो पहले नहीं था. So, पहले के dictionaries में आप देखोगे तो selfie नाम का कोई भी शब्द नहीं है, ना उसका definition है. So, stipulative definition means जो भी newly coined terms हैं, उनको जब हम define करते हैं, तो उस definition को बोला जाता है stipulative definition. The next kind of definition is precising definition. For example, कोई एक definition जो एक particular situation के लिए fit होती है. आप movies देखने जाते हैं, movies में लिखा जाता है that students must show their ID cards. Now, here the word student reflects any person who is below 18 years. So, rather than writing below 18 years must show their ID cards, they have written students must show their ID cards. So, student यहाँ पे defined है any person who is under 18 years of age. So, this is a precising definition. Precisely used for that particular situation. एक school में student की definition बहुत different है और एक movie hall में student की definition different है. The third kind of definition is persuasive definition. जब आप किसी को pursue करना चाहते हैं, कुछ सोचने पे मजबूर करना चाहते हैं. A person who is against abortion might define abortion as a murder of an innocent person. Murder of an innocent child in the womb. This is a definition of abortion given by a person who hates abortion. So you can see that this definition is trying to pursue you to think about abortion in a very negative way. So these are some important kinds of definitions jo exam mein puchi jati hai. They might ask you what is a persuasive definition. They'll give you four options. You need to decide which of them is correct. Or they will give you the definition and they'll ask you that which kind of definition is this. Then you need to decide that whether it is stipulative or whether it is argumentative or whether it is persuasive. After looking at the theoretical section, it's time to look at the practical portion coming from logical reasoning. So the first kind of practical question that you will come across is Venn diagram. Now what are Venn diagrams? Venn diagrams are basically tools that are used to represent complex relationship. For example, if I say that A set of people represents honest people, B set of people are sincere people, and C set of people are politicians, and I ask you that please tell me which of this set or which of this portion means sincere, honest politician. So if you can see, the intersection point of these three sets is the portion where you will find people who are honest, who are sincere, and also who are politicians. So this kind of complex relationship is denoted by the use of Venn diagrams. They sometimes give you Venn diagrams and ask question based on the Venn diagram, or they sometimes give you questions in which you have to make a Venn diagram and then answer the question. The next kind of question are premise and conclusion based question. In these questions, you will be given premise and you will be given a set of conclusions. Looking at the premise, you need to tell which of the conclusion is correct. In these questions, you have to make a Venn diagram in order to correctly look and find out the conclusion. For example, if I give you a question that all religious people are emotional and Aditya is emotional, so what is the conclusion? If you look at the Venn diagram, you'll see that if all the religious people are under the emotional set and if Aditya is an emotional person, then we can conclude that Aditya is religious. The next kind of questions are assertion reason questions. मैंने देखा है कि ये questions ना सिर्फ paper 1 में आते हैं but paper 2 में भी आते हैं. So you need to be very good at solving such questions, because अगर assertion reason questions आपको नहीं आते तो आप बहुत सारे marks अपने lose कर देंगे. And इन्हें solve करना बहुत easy है. हम एक example से समझेंगे. Assertion is a statement and reason बता रहा है कि वो assertion ऐसा क्यों है. For example, मैं अगर आपको बोलती हूँ that the assertive statement is we feel colder on mountains. हमें mountains पे ज़्यादा ठंड लगती है. Reason है temperature declines with altitude. जितनी height पे आप जाएंगे उतना temperature decrease होगा. ठीक है, अगर मैं प्लेन्स पे रह रही हूँ तो टेम्परेचर इज 30 डिग्री, मैं माउंटेन्स पे जाऊँगी टेम्परेचर विल बी 5 डिग्री, तो 5 डिग्री पे ऑब्वियसली ज़्यादा ठंड लगेगी. सो अब असर्शन क्या है? एक स्टेटमेंट. और रीज़न बता रहा है कि असर्शन वाला स्टेटमेंट ट्रू क्यों है, क्या रीज़न है. तो हमें ठंड क्यों लगती है? क्योंकि टेम्परेचर डिक्रीज होता है विथ ऑल्टीट्यूड. अब सबसे पहले इस क्वेश्चन को सॉल्व करने के लिए आपको असर्शन और रीजन क्वेश्चन स्टेटमेंट को देखना होगा. असर्शन स्टेटमेंट को देख के बताइए क्या ये सही है. इफ इट इज ट्रू देन मार्क टी इन फ्रंट ऑफ असर्शन. देन लुक एट द रीजन स्टेटमेंट. क्या रीजन स्टेटमेंट सही है? क्या टेम्परेचर डिक्रीज होता है जब हम हायर ऑल्टीट्यूड्स पे जाते हैं? डेफिनेटली डिक्रीजेस. सो रीजन स्टेटमेंट इज ऑल्सो ट्रू. सो अब आपने सबसे पहला स्टेप क्या किया कि आपने असर्शन और रीजन स्टेटमेंट को अलग अलग देखा और फिर आपने देखा कि क्या दोनों स्टेटमेंट सही है या कोई एक गलत है. अब अगर ये आपने देख लिया तो आप अगर अपने ऑप्शंस में देखेंगे तो एक ऑप्शन है असर्शन इज ट्रू एंड रीजन इज ट्रू. एंड नाउ लुक एट द लिंक बिटवीन दीज टू स्टेटमेंट. अगर आपने असर्शन रीजन के बाद में बिकॉज लगा के रीजन स्टेटमेंट लगाया तो क्या दिस स्टेटमेंट इज मेकिंग सेंस? इफ दिस स्टेटमेंट इज मेकिंग सेंस दैट मीन्स रीजन इज अ करेक्ट एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ असर्शन. सो दिस इज हाउ यू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन. सबसे पहले आपको असर्शन और रीजन क्वेश्चन को स्टेटमेंट्स को अलग अलग देखना होता है. कई बार ऐसा होगा कि असर्शन स्टेटमेंट गलत होगा या रीजन स्टेटमेंट गलत होगा. इन दैट कैटेगरी यू विल गेट ईदर ऑफ द टू ऑप्शंस. नंबर वन, असर्शन इज ट्रू बट रीजन इज फॉल्स, और असर्शन इज फॉल्स बट रीजन इज ट्रू. ये दो कैटेगरी आपको तब पता चलेगी जब आप असर्शन और रीजन स्टेटमेंट को अलग अलग देखेंगे. तो आपको पता चल जाएगा कि इनमें से कोई एक गलत है. दैट मीन्स आपका जो ऑप्शन है वो या तो फर्स्ट होगा असर्शन इज ट्रू एंड रीजन इज फॉल्स, या फिर सेकेंड होगा असर्शन इज फॉल्स एंड रीजन इज ट्रू. अगर दोनों स्टेटमेंट सही है जैसे कि इस क्वेश्चन में है, उस केस में आपको थर्ड या फोर्थ ऑप्शन में से एक ऑप्शन सही मिलेगा. असर्शन एंड रीजन बोथ आर ट्रू बट रीजन इज नॉट अ करेक्ट एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ असर्शन, या फिर असर्शन एंड रीजन बोथ आर ट्रू एंड रीजन इज अ करेक्ट एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ असर्शन. सो अगर आप थर्ड फोर्थ स्टेटमेंट देखते हैं तो आपको पता चलेगा कि इस कैटेगरी में फोर्थ स्टेटमेंट इज ट्रू. Assertion and reason both are true and reason is a correct explanation of assertion. But agar main reason statement mein dalti that sky is blue. Now this is not a explanation of assertion. We feel cold on the mountains because the sky is blue. No, this is false. Both assertion and reason statements are true. Sky is blue. But still, असर्शन स्टेटमेंट का करेक्ट एक्सप्लेनेशन रीजन नहीं दे रहा. सो इन दिस केस थर्ड ऑप्शन इज करेक्ट, विच इज असर्शन एंड रीजन आर ट्रू बट रीजन इज नॉट अ करेक्ट एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ असर्शन. सो आपने समझा, आपको दो स्टेप्स में इस क्वेश्चन को डिवाइड करना है. पहले स्टेप में आप नॉर्मली असर्शन और रीजन स्टेटमेंट को अलग अलग पढ़ेंगे और देखेंगे क्या वो सही है या गलत. अगर सही है तो टी मार्क कर दीजिए, अगर गलत है तो एफ मार्क कर दीजिए. अगर एक भी गलत है तो आपके ए या बी में से एक ऑप्शन सही होगा. बट अगर दोनों सही है तो आपको एक स्टेप फर्दर जाके बिकॉज लगा के दोनों स्टेटमेंट को देखना है. फिर आपको पता चलेगा क्या असर्शन और रीजन स्टेटमेंट के बीच में लिंक है या नहीं. सो दिस इज हाउ यू सॉल्व एनी असर्शन रीजन क्वेश्चन. वी कम ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन दैट यू विल फाइंड इन लॉजिकल रीजनिंग सेक्शन, which is verbal analogy. Now, verbal analogy is one of the most easiest kind of questions you'll see in the paper. You are just asked to find the link between two words. For example, they'll give you a question like clock is to time, then thermometer is to watt. Now, if you convert this into a sentence, you'll say clock tells time, then thermometer tells watt, then thermometer tells temperature. So the correct option is temperature. So I'm giving you a short homework. I would like to know your views in the comment section. I'm giving you a question which you need to solve and tell me the correct answer in the comment section. The question is, if light is to blind, then speech is to what? If light is to blind, then speech is to what? So put your answers in the comment section and let me see how far you are able to solve the verbal analogies correctly. So we come on to the last kind of questions that you will find in logical reasoning section, and that are the questions related to square of opposition. You must be wondering what are square of opposition because you have never heard the term probably. But I will tell you a question which you might have seen in the paper frequently. The question goes like this. Among the following propositions, two propositions are related in such a manner that they both cannot be false but they both can be true. You need to find the two propositions and they'll give you four propositions. Now, when you look at the question, you feel as if this question requires like 5 to 10 minutes of your time, only then you can solve it. But I'm telling you a short trick which you can use to solve such questions within seconds. The short trick is square of opposition. Square of opposition is a concept jise aap samajh jate hain, to is type ke questions ko solve karna bahut easy ho jata hai. Within 30 seconds you can solve this question. Bahut simple concept hai, but thoda sa time consuming hai. I would not be able to incorporate this in this video lecture, so my request is that go to YouTube, type square of opposition. You'll get a lot of YouTubers talking about how to solve such question, understand how square of opposition works, and then test yourself. I'm telling you, if you understand the concept of square of opposition, then these kind of questions would be a cakewalk for you. It's a very, very interesting concept and you'll love it once you understand it. You might have to put in a bit efforts to understand it for the first time, but once you master it, then I'm telling you, you will fall in love with this concept. So with that note, I end my discussion on logical reasoning. I've tried to give you a blueprint of all sort of questions that can come up in the exam and how to tackle those questions. I hope that this video was informative and it helped you in channelizing your preparation. If you like this video, then don't forget to give it a big fan thumbs up. Also subscribe to this channel because I post videos every weekend in order to help UGC NET aspirants in their preparation. You can also follow me on the social media platforms where I post the recent updates of UGC NET, of NTA, and also I am running this free Go NET quiz. You can go to my website arpitakarwa.com. All the previous year papers are there on the website. You can find them and then practice those papers in order to prepare well. Apart from that, if you are preparing for UGC NET English, then you can also join my online course in which I'm providing 700 plus audio lectures, 200 plus PDFs and 200 plus mock tests. So if you are really interested in clearing NET this time, then this is one of the biggest opportunity you can get. That's it for this video. We'll meet very soon in the next video lecture. Till the time we meet next, happy learning, keep loving literature, and stay tuned to arpitakarwa.com.